course, we all know that Malta suffered terribly in the Second World War, mainly from Axis bombing. And the principal defense from Axis bombing was obviously, okay, had the anti-aircraft guns, but the primary defense were the fighters which defended Malta from the Axis bombers and fighters. So obviously the plane's offensive armament was principally, because it was the British forces, were principally 303.303 caliber machine guns. 303 was the caliber used by the British in their rifles, in their infantry rifles, but obviously, and machine guns. But obviously, in an aircraft, you want a rapid firing gun, and that obviously the machine gun was the weapon of choice. Although some aircraft carried also larger caliber cannon, which were also automatic. So this example is a machine gun which came off an aircraft which was involved almost certainly in the battle for Malta in the Second World War. It is a British manufactured gun, but it is based on the Browning model 1919. And this was used on various aircraft, by the Americans, with a different designation, different from this design, but not very different. The shape would be quite similar, but the machinery would be different, and I will explain. So what the British did is, there was an American aircraft machine gun based on the John Moses Browning, the Browning model 1919 infantry machine gun. And this machine gun was adopted by the British for use on their aircraft. So originally the Browning model 1919 water cooled was designed for tanks, but then it was adopted by the infantry. The British did not use it in the infantry configuration. They used it possibly rarely, but they used it principally as an aircraft machine gun. But there was a problem. The problem was that the Browning model 1919 and its aircraft adaptation, specifically the one copied by the British, was the Colt model 40, M40. It fired from a closed bolt. So if I manage to open it, this is the bolt in the closed position. So the round would be inside the barrel, and the gun, this has a trigger. This is the mechanical trigger. This is like a little trigger, but there's no trigger guard because this is an aircraft configuration. But it was fired either with pneumatic, air, or hydraulic trigger. So you wanted to fire this, with by the pilot pressing a button on the joystick on the aircraft controls, and it would obviously trigger the gun through hydraulic or pneumatic air pressure. So that was the trigger. So the bolt would be in the American configuration. It would be closed in the forward position with a round in the chamber. But with the British, it was a problem because the 303 round, as a contrast to the American 30-06, the original caliber for this machine gun in the American configuration, the British 303 was more likely to cook off. And because in an aircraft you would be firing maybe bursts of fire, the barrels could be quite hot. And because this was not water-cooled, it was air-cooled, it might get red hot. And the British rounds had a tendency to fire off based on just from the heat from the barrel. So to prevent this, they were converted so that the bolt would be fixed in an open position. And when you pull the trigger, the bolt would slam forwards, draw around, and then fire. So this is the open bolt configuration. I will not move the bolt because it requires a special tool to cock the gun. You can do it with your finger, but it's rather uncomfortable. So this is in the closed bolt. So this would be fired position, but it's actually in the British configuration, it would be set so that the bolt would be held open when the gun is not firing and being prepared for firing. Air would come in through the barrel, would then cool the barrel faster, and in the open bolt configuration, the barrel would tend to be cooler, which helped to solve the problem with the rounds cooking off. Also, when you fired, if the bolt closes, it would fire automatically, immediately, and therefore the round would not have time to heat up and explode. It would be fired immediately. So this solved the problem. There was another problem. The problem was with the front. The the booster, so when it was fired, and the force of the gases to push back the mechanism and recock the gun, there was some fouling at the front here with the of the booster with the British ammunition, and they modified that as well. So those are the major changes from the American gun. Open bolt rather than closed bolt, obviously the ammunition caliber, American 30-06, in the British it's 303, and changes to the booster. In fact, there were some modifications to the front of the gun with the booster and also the flash hider. And this, the, in the British service, this was not called the Browning. It was called the Browning, but it was called the Mark I. The 303 Mark I was the first adaptation, but then you had the Mark I Star, then the Mark II, and the Mark II Star. And these mainly had differences principally in the booster and the flash hider. This firearm was weapon or firearm was mounted on a Hurricane or a Spitfire stationed in Malta. This was also used in, for example, the Ferry Fulmar, which is the naval aircraft. It was also the standard gun, which was mounted on, for example, the Lanchesters and the Wellingtons and other aircraft, Blenheims, that had turreted guns, turret-mounted guns. It was also used as a secondary armament on other aircraft, like, for example, the Mosquito. There were some versions of the Mosquito that mounted these 303s. Wherever there was a 303, basically, this was this particular model, the Mark I or Mark II, the Mark I or Mark II with Star, Mark I Star, Mark II Star, these variants. What's particularly interesting about this particular gun is its serial number. This gun has a BYJ3134348B serial number, and this special series of serial numbers, and there are also some modifications to the gun in the fact of little minor details which are different from all other Brownings which you find, which have been mounted on aircraft throughout the Second World War. This particular gun was made by an unknown manufacturer. So we do not know who the manufacturer was. We know that there are slight differences in some of the parts. They were machined slightly differently. And we know that they had this special serial number range. We don't know who the manufacturer was. We know that there are approximately 16 guns in existence. One is in the Royal, in the Pattern Room. Another one is in the Imperial War Museum. And there are two of these in Malta. One of these is this one. So this is a particularly rare firearm. Obviously, it was belt-fed on the aircraft specifically. It would be feeding, I think, from the left. I'm not sure if you actually could convert it to feed from the other side if it was required with respect to the configuration of the guns as they're mounted on the aircraft. Obviously, you have the jacket to help cooling of the barrel. You have parts of the gun which are also machined in different metals. I believe this is aluminium, but most of it is obviously steel. And you have the mounting bracket here, which allows it with this hinge here, and this is the locking part of mechanism to allow it to be mounted, obviously, on the aircraft. And you would have then obviously the controls, the supply of the hydraulic pressure or the pneumatic pressure to fire the gun. This is the trigger which would be used in the infantry configuration or ground or tank mounted, but obviously it would be fired, I believe, through this. It would be fired with this true distance, obviously, on an aircraft. Rounds were ejected down, including links from below the bolt. And the mechanism, that's rather heavy, excuse me. The mechanism was otherwise, except for the closed bolt, quite similar to the American variant. So I thank you for your interest, and I will now show you something related to this also, which was also used in Malta. Thank you.